is Absolute Radio.
You always hear about record deal, you know, the shiny thing. I think a couple of them had heard my tracks, and I met Daniel Glass from Glassnote, which is an indie label. Mm. You know, it wasn't like, I'm going to make you the next pop star. It was like, care about great albums, and if you think you could make a great album, then we can work together.
Jade Bird, welcome to Absolute Radio. How are you doing?
Thank you. I'm really, really well. Yeah, it was a lot of fun. It's good to be here.
We've been playing your singles over the past few months, and just hearing those in a stripped back form, I was most bowled over by the power of your voice behind them. Because of course you hear the recorded version, but live, just stripped back with an acoustic guitar. I was absolutely bowled over. I think it's incredible. When did you find that confidence in your voice?
I think it comes from, like, you know, years of playing live. Like, I started playing live when I was 14 in pubs and clubs. And I think with noisy rooms, you kind of have to find a voice, or you just, there's no real point in playing because no one can really hear you. I learned that in London. There was this blues bar I played at called Spiritual Bar in Camden. Uh-huh. And, like, the owner, Raf, he was a bit of a mentor for me for a really long time. And kind of was like, you know, you need to get a voice. And I was listening to loads of powerful female voices at the time, and it just kind of spread, really.
Can you name check any of those for us?
I love Patti Smith. I love her poetry. She kind of shouts in her poetry. She's like, and I just kind of always admired that. I love Tori Amos right now, though. Uh-huh. I mean, I'm obsessed at the moment. I'm in a proper Tori Amos pit.
Go through chapters, don't you, where things just click and you're like, sonically or lyrically or whatever. But
yeah, and when they do, you're just obsessed. And I think the people like her and classic artists like her, there's just so much. It's like a well-led discography. So you're in great ears.
It's fun, isn't it? You've got a lot to listen back to.
Absolutely.
So let's start at the very beginning. We'll do a quick recap because it's been talked about a lot of times that you've lived all over the world. Your parents were in the army, so you travelled a lot. And you lived in different places. Did you have one favourite? Because you lived in London, you lived in Germany, you lived...
Yeah.
Was there one that sticks in your mind that you like the best?
That's a tricky question. I mean, I really like Germany. I was probably about 5 to 7 years old. And I think that time when you're in your childhood is kind of idyllic anyway. For some reason, you're just not really focused on, you know, the boring things, you know, at school and stuff. You're more like, oh, there's a tree at the end of the street. That's
fantastic.
I love
that tree.
You know, there's
you
horses.
Get this tree in Germany.
Yeah. Exactly. And I think that obviously lends a fondness in my mind for where I've lived. But I've always been more about people because of moving.
Sure.
You know, locations don't necessarily hold the same sentimental value for me. For
home is where the heart is, that old
saying.
You know,
where your family is. It's so true.
Yeah, absolutely. And then you were in London, of course. Brit school, you went in for the first time. Didn't get in the first time. You were like, I ain't having that. You went back a second time.
When I was 16. Because when you're 16, there's not a lot. If you're in certain areas, like I was in South Wales and in Bridgend, and if you want to do the arts, like, it's tough. Unless you're Welsh speaking, which I wasn't, it's very tough. So me and my mum decided to kind of take the leap and move to London together.
Was that primarily, sorry to interrupt you, primarily for your music?
Yes, absolutely.
Wow,
mum's
been a huge support of you.
Oh, ridiculously so. And not in a kind of pushy way. I think she's worked so hard herself her whole life. And I think she was like, if you want to make it work, you know, you'd prove to me that you want to do it. And I was just writing hundreds of songs, and I was going to these competitions and getting my poor little heart broken when they were like, you know, you're rubbish, you don't get in. You don't come any places. And then, she was like, okay. And I did the same thing in London. I kind of had to make it work a bit. So
which was the point that suddenly went from that part of your life into you sitting here now, the record deal? You know, what was the moment, you think, that clicked?
It's not overnight. I think, you know, one thing I say to artists, it's like a culmination of a lot of good decisions in terms of people. Like, the world runs on people. And I think, for example, my label, I found my management through a lawyer at the booze bar. I talk about Spiritual Bar. He saw me and introduced me to a few people. And then label, you know, because you always hear about record deal, you know, the shiny thing. I think a couple of them had heard my tracks, and I met Daniel Glass from Glassnote, which is an indie label, and I just felt like our values aligned. You know, it wasn't like, I'm gonna make you the next pop star. It was like, care about great albums, and if you think you could make a great album, then we can work together. And I really aligned with that view.
Absolutely. And seeing something as a career artist and not just, you know, sort of you know, streaming hit. You know, it's like the career, the whole thing, like you were saying about Patti Smith and the back catalogue, isn't it?
Yeah, and I hope to, I hope that the first album isn't the best album. You know, you want to make sure that your third or your fourth is just something spectacular, like a classic record. That's what everyone should be aiming for if you're in it for the music, because that's like the perfection you only get
when
you're late 20s. A lot of the artists we love, like Jeff Buckley, Tori, and I was like, they're late 20s. You know, so you need to work towards it, I always feel.
Absolutely. You've just turned 21, you were just
saying. Baby,
yeah, and the debut album is coming out next month. So can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, I mean, it's my debut record. It's kind of your life in a way, in a few words. I've written tons for it, you know, since I was young. A lot of it's quite new. I always thought I'd never be able to write a record, write a song while being happy, you know, while being in love. And I wrote half this record in that space, which was a revelation for me because I just didn't think it could happen. You've got kind of songs like Love Has All Been Done Before, Aha, which is me exploring that kind of visceral, like gritty nature of alternative music. Mm-hmm. And also these moments like If I Die and My Motto, which are just like kind of torn from some place, you know, deep inside me, and they mean so much. Mm-hmm. So yeah, it's total range of emotions, like everything.
Wow, interesting. I can't wait to hear it, actually.
From start to finish.
Just seeing you perform those three tracks, I was astounded by your performance. And
everyone that's going to
see you this summer is in for a massive treat.
Yeah.
Your band, if we can talk about that.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't believe everything I read online.
Yeah.
Is your drummer someone who played for Jeff Buckley in a past life?
So in the recording process, we basically recorded everything in almost a live setup.
Yeah.
You know, we do the tracks and then you take takes that you like. And what the person who featured the most on the drum recording on this record was Matt Johnson.
Yeah.
Who was the drummer on Jeff Buckley's Grace.
Wow.
And who's just a phenomenal person, and I don't think I've ever learned so much from a musician. Like, just a great, great person, and a pleasure to have him on the record.
Amazing. And Will from Mystery Jets, did I read as well?
Yeah. Yeah, Will plays a lot for us still.
Yeah.
We were playing with Caps for a while as well from the Mystery Jets, but Will, he's got this kind of crazy, untamable, chaotic guitar style. And for where I'm heading at the moment, it's just perfect.
Yeah.
You know, he comes in and he does a Will, and it's fantastic.
Does a Will.
He's a great musician. Yeah.
Wicked. Of course, we'll be playing it on air and celebrating the debut release from you. Congratulations. It's been a phenomenal year last year, and I'm sure this year your diary's looking pretty busy.
Yeah, so fingers crossed it all goes well. I'm just excited to share it.
Oh, it will. Japer, thank you so much. Thank you.
Enjoying yourself? I hope so, because we get a warm glow when you like our videos. So subscribe for more of the same. Plus, ring the bell icon when you subscribe, and we'll even tell you personally when there's a new one up.